Our three MOOCs, we share very common, some common interesting and some common focus that we can work together and collaboration in many activities and area. So very happy to say that. So for our new participants that did not come yesterday, I would like to let you know that we have some agreement and make a MOU among three of our MOOC platform, and then maybe we can work closely to do many activities together. Okay, I would like to present about the Thai MOOC, maybe short and brief, very brief. As all of our most of our participants, we are in this Thai MOOC project. Maybe some professors, many professors are in the Thai MOOC project, so you maybe don't know about my presentation very well. So you can add, if I miss something after my presentation, you can add more to make it more complete. Okay. For the MOOC, Thai MOOC platform, I would like to say that it start from the higher education side. When we start the project, we looking at the weakness of the higher education, and we try to use the MOOC as a strategy to solve the weakness. But they develop from time to time. The first weakness is we learn from the statistic that only 40% of students of secondary school students that have university opportunity can enter or admission to the university. So maybe 60% was left out. So how to open opportunity for them? Maybe we have some way of education to prepare for them, and also that is the demand side from the supply side, from the university side. The growth of the university, the establishment of the university, they grow very fast. Now we have 157 universities, and both in public and higher education, but less than 30 of them from the 157, less than 30 of them was found more than 30 years. So mean that we are have a lot of young university that maybe have some difficulty or very new faculty member. So we have a wide range of university from the very old, very well equipped and full, a lot of professor and very new professor, very new university with not much resources at this. So a wide range of university quality, and as the world ranking chart, Thailand university are not perform well compared to other university outside. So that is the demand side. So we have problem both in supply, both in demand side and supply side, and also from the Office of Higher Education Commission, they have the long range plan every 15 years, and they announce that the university have role that to take care of the people who working in the industry. So many people, more than 30 million people in the industry or in the working area, that university have to take care or have to training them to increase the potential of their working, not only the student in the university. So this is the rationale that we create the Thai MOOC. So Thai MOOC starting from addressing the crisis in higher education. I call the crisis. I think there are many problems that happened in the university. But this is the summarized. We cannot compete with overseas university. We have too many universities. We have 60% of students that do not have opportunity, something like this. So we start to create the project Thai MOOC under Thailand Cyber University, under the Office of Higher Education Commission. This is the first starting. And we're looking at the network. We know that we are ready at the technology side, technical side. We have a uninet that links not only the university but also many schools. We have more than 20,000 schools linked in the uninet network. Okay, so we thinking that we established the Thai MOOC to address the difficulty in higher education. And we just start the project maybe 1 year, and then there come the policy from the government. Government run the policy about Thailand digital economy in 2014, nearly 2015, Thailand digital economy. This policy would like to improve the capacity of the country. So many strategy what have established in the policy. For example, the 20-year Thailand digital landscape, they will move forward Thailand from now, the current one, to be the digital country and have a digital economy and boost the economy of the country. But under this strategy, there are one strategy that create the equal opportunity for everyone and have one strategy that, sorry that the slide cannot read very well, I will read for you. Strategy 3, create a knowledge-driven digital society. Under this strategy, they have one sub-strategy that to provide education for all, to make the people more digital literacy. And under that sub-strategy, they mention about use the ICT, use the MOOC as a way to provide education. So under this policy, the government support another budget and to Thai MOOC. So now Thai MOOC have two background rationale. The first to address the crisis of higher education, and the second to make the building the capacity of the people and make them more digital literacy. Okay, and before we starting Thai MOOC, there are major content portal under Ministry of Education. They are under Office of Basic Education, Office of Vocational Education, and some portals are under other ministry. So many portals. So how can we consolidate? How can we link our portal to create a central portal so it benefits all people that who want to learn something? They do not have to go many portals to learn many things. So they come the policy from the government that how to make together, link together the content portal. At the starting time, maybe to 2015, the policy that how to make all portal link together and make a lifelong learning space. So many ministries come together and we work together, cooperation, to create the Thai MOOC. So there are Ministry of Science and Technology, Ministry of Information and Communication Technology at that time. Now they change the name to Ministry of Digital Economy. Yeah. Now they change to address the policy of the government and also Ministry of Education. Under the Ministry of Education, there are many commissions, so we try to negotiate each other, we try to talk to each other. how you can build a central platform and provide content to all, so it's more convenient and more easily for the learner or student. This is our conceptual that everyone can learn from the portal, the central portal, the Thai MOOC portal, and they can learn from their whole life, from the very young age until their school age or university or after university, and their learning, what keep in their learning portfolio. Yeah, and their any courses that they pass, they can keep in the credit bank, for example. So this is the ultimate goal, our dream, that we would like to see this lifelong learning platform, but still did not happen yet. We looking forward to maybe in not near, maybe a little bit intermediate or maybe long time, but we hope that one day they may be happen. So the objective of Thai MOOC is to develop Thai MOOC as alternative education delivery model to adopt Thai MOOC pedagogy and strengthen partnership among university, and also to build the central platform, because central platform will minimize the investment cost. As we know that under the education provided via ICT, we need a strong and reliable technology, maybe the hardware, the software, and also we need very professional engineer to take care of the system. So this is a lot of investment. If we invest this kind of system in many universities, so it's a large amount of money we have to invest. So if we can invest in one central platform and utilize for all universities, so that will be more benefit to the countries at the broad level. So we starting Thai MOOC by talking to Ministry of Science and Technology and invite them to be partner and ask them to be the organization that take care of the platform development. So yesterday you see Dr. Chai, Mr. Porn Chai from the NECTECH, National Electronic and Computer Technology Education Center, that come to attend yesterday meeting. They come from Ministry of Science and Technology, and they take care of the platform development. And also Ministry of Digital Economy, they are funding agency, they provide budget for us and try to support other resources. And Ministry of Education will be the one who create the content, pedagogy and service. So we try to work together among three ministries to make everything good for all. Infrastructure, platform, application, and also content providing. This is our conceptual model to address all learners, that we have content, we have courses, MOOC courses, and also we have many types of learner. So the learner that who want to learn without any credit, they can learn and finish, get certificate without any credit. But for if we provide the MOOC course that have credit, then if the learner want to get the credit, they have to go to the examination center to do the offline exam to prove that they know and they understand they achieve that course. And if they pass the examination, so their record of pass you keep in the credit bank. Okay. And we hope that in the near future, if they pass, if someone pass many courses, maybe they can collect all credit that they pass and maybe get transfer to university degree, or maybe transfer and learn additional courses and then get a degree in the future. Also, we looking forward to that if we can make a central platform, if we can share the central data, for example, the user account. So everyone have one user and one password. They can learn from their whole life, from their younger time, their working time, or after retire, they can use the same user and password. And that create benefit to them because they can keep their learning record and they can show as their performance to their boss, to their organization, or maybe they use the learning record and to apply for new job, something, and also apply for a university degree or bachelor, master, or maybe more advanced degree. So that our conceptual model. This is the model from the technology from the system model. You can see that the MOOC on the blue brown rectangle. This is the MOOC, but we also think about maybe not only the MOOC course, but maybe some small content, maybe as a OER, you can encourage the educator, encourage the one who have content to provide, but not in the whole course. They can share under the OER portal, and maybe if they share under the OER portal, the teacher that who want to create the MOOC course, they can use some OER from the portal and combine to become a big content of big courses. So we encourage the share and create and share culture among teachers. So we provide many tools for them, and we provide the central authentication service and also the system for do as a e-testing in the examination site. This is the concept of the picture. Okay. I would like to mention about our current process. We are in the phase one that we got the budget from the government, and then we starting to ask universities to create the MOOC course, and then we will provide open the MOOC course and provide to all in this April 2017. Now they are very busy about create the MOOC course. But our Thai MOOC strategy, we use another angle. We did not select university. We have in Thailand we have 157 universities, right? But we cluster the university into 9 areas. In the north, we have 2 areas, upper north, lower north. In the center, we have upper center, lower center. Each area, we have one major university, one big university that may be the coordinator. We call the, what do you call, okay, matter, university hub. In that region, so we have totally 9 university hub. The hub is the major university. So we work like a network. So we invite the university hub to have a meeting. We have project Thai MOOC, and this is the way to provide education. Do you interesting to join? And please bring the project and to meeting with the university in your region and ask for volunteer who would like to join. But we have a guideline that the university that would like to join should create a course that address the policy, and you or you create a course that may be benefit to your region, or the course that you can share among each other university in the region, just as the guideline. So the university at the hub university in the region, they're starting to work with the university in those regions. Now, in this meeting, we have to have university join us. Wallailak University, Dr. Sakon, and also Pin Songkha, Nakhalin University, Dr. Thakeng. We have two of them. So after my presentation, you can add something. We work like a network from the Thai MOOC, from the Office of Higher Education. We work as a network to the Hub University, and Hub University work to the university in the region as a network. Totally now we have 140 courses from all university, from seven region. We have nine region, but only seven region work with us. Totally maybe more than 1,400 something hour from 42 university. Many areas, sorry, I do not translate into English. Many areas from the lifelong learning, from the daily life knowledge to use in daily life, knowledge to use in take care of their health, knowledge to use in a very, very casual way to the university courses. We have many showcases. For example, Khonkan University will open one MOOC courses and provide it as a general education. General education means the courses that students learn in the first year. General education, first year, and they will open this course for the student to learn via the MOOC course. No need to attend to the class. They will try to pilot this kind of thing called Payao University in the north. Payao University will pilot use MOOC course for prepare students before enter the university. In Thailand, the students, when they finish their learning and their admission to the university, they will finish on March, and then they have to wait 4 months, April, May, June, July. They have to wait 4 months before they start their learning in August in university. So a lot of time, one university, Payao University, they think that they will create a MOOC course and let the student that was accept or was admission to the Payao University, they assign them to learn that course before enter the university to prepare the student more ready for university learning. This is Payao. And Mahidol University, they create a lot of MOOC courses, and they plan to use the MOOC courses in their free learning in the university in the next semester. So many model create. Also, Mahidol University, another group, they develop the MOOC courses for build up the digital literacy of students. And this is a project from the Ministry of Digital Economy. And also many other universities create the MOOC course to do a professional development at the certificate level. And also many courses for lifelong learning. I would like to mention about the next phase of Thai MOOC. The first phase, we address the university crisis. We address the digital literacy of the people, lifelong learning of the people. But the second phase, there come another new policy from the government. We call Thailand 4.0. The Thailand 4.0 would like to move the country more innovative, more creative in the industry to make the economic a little bit go more fast. So very innovative thing. So the second phase of Thai MOOC, we submit the proposal that we would like to use the MOOC as a way to strengthen the capacity of the working people in the industry, and also that will benefit the student that will graduate from the university to enter the industry, so prepare them ready for the industry, and also can use to capacity building of the people that working earlier. So that in the second phase of Thai MOOC, and also for some courses, small courses that very popular, very famous, or very quality one, maybe we support them to create the whole courses, credit courses, and start to do some pilot credit recognition course. The challenges of Thai MOOC also similar to both K-MOOC and J-MOOC. We are the project that supported by the government and the budget. As the Dr. Su said, that maybe the budget cannot be last long, so how we can sustain the MOOC education, this model, so we need to think very much about the sustainability model of the Thai MOOC platform. And also we face many problems about how to clarify the copyright issues of the content in the provider dimension, also in the user, how can we let them use the content, what we call under the allow Creative Commons or under the agreement, not misuse the content, something like this. We still find the good way to advocate the copyright issue. And also the pedagogy of MOOC education, because we starting from maybe from the ground that we do not know many things, so we trial and error, so we need to find the good pedagogy that appropriate to Thai people. Maybe Thai people maybe not similar to other country or US or the Western country. We need to find the good, the proper pedagogy, also the quality assurance, how we can improve the quality of MOOC courses. And also the accreditation and credit transfer that I mentioned earlier, that is still has a dream. We still have to find the strategy to accept by the Ministry of Education, and also the university is still comfortable to follow this guideline. That the strategy to move forward Thai MOOC as a lifelong learning platform to all, how can we convince our content provider partner in every ministry, and also in every commission under the Ministry of Education, that we can cooperation and provide the content at the same central portal that will benefit all. We have to find good strategy that benefit all. Okay, that very short and brief about the rationale, objective, and the current situation and the future and the challenges of the Thai MOOC. So other participants, you are involved in the project. So if I miss something, and you want to mention some challenges in your region, maybe two of our seven regions at 10 hours meeting now, you can add more, or you can ask, you can comment or recommend something. And also TCU team, Dr. Kamola, Dr. from FCO, you can comment on. Thank you very much. Oh, no time. Michael say no time.
before I'll give him a big hand. Thank you. Before no time, let me discuss with you about this. There are going to be two presentations after this from Professor Yoshimi and Professor Im. Each of you initially given 45 minutes each, but we have roughly about 1 hour left, so 30 minutes each. We can continue talking about this together and then move one presentation to the afternoon. So cut afternoon one a little shorter. Or what? Okay, continue. All right, so then questions, please, or comment, please.
You can comment or you can discuss or something. Maybe let me set that maybe 5 minutes, okay? 5 or 10 minutes, okay. But no more questions. Maybe we can talk after this. Or you can, do you have anything, Dr. Saturn or Dr. Asasit, to comment? Yes, please.
One question. Maybe the future plan, but do you have the plan for the charged content from the runners you charge?
You mean the app there?
Payment for me.
Cost fee,
yes.
No.
First, you start from the complement, free courses. But do you have the future plan for the
required
payment for the courses for runners?
As mentioned, we should buy a good business sustainability model. But up until now, we got the budget from the government, so our policy is when we got budget and we can pay the cost, so we provide it for free. And next year we still got another budget, so we think that we still have to think about the sustainability model. Maybe in the near future, we should have some strategy to share costs. And also from the research, it's very interesting that the courses that charge free to the learner, they are small proportion of students that drop out, but the courses that provide for free, a large proportion of students that drop out. This from the research side, but we still think about the sustainability model. We have to charge some more. Maybe Professor Subhani has something to add.
This is the thing that we think that a little bit challenge for us in the future. We have thought about this, that maybe in the future, if someone would like the credit from us, they have to pay. And in the same time, if they want credit from some university, they can pay for that. And sometimes pay for the examination or something like that. So the cooperation among our center here and then the university will be better because they can get benefit from this also. So that will be a little bit something that gain sustainability in the future. And one more thing that I would like to add about some challenge thing about our project here is that because we are under a government project, the regulation and rules for doing things here a little bit very hard. For example, the budget that provide for us 6 months ago, but right now we cannot get it. You know, they just tell that, okay, you got this money, but how to get to take out that money? Very, very hard. That's an obstacle of this project. Maybe in the future we have to find some way to solve this, to make it go really smooth and then as quick as we think, so we can run maybe after some country like Korea or Japan, so you go really fast, but it's slow. That's very slow. Thank you.
Can I add a little bit? First of all, I would like to thank for Thai MOOC to give the opportunity for my university to offer the alternative MOOC. And then we accidentally found out, because what we do, we try to do R&D, action, participatory action research along the way. And then we found out that at the beginning, we have a quick survey, hey, what you want? And then we feed them what they want. And for example, we start up with the local tourism or the green farming system. And then along the way, we found out that especially about the green farming system, they're saying that, okay, you gave me the fundamental knowledge about the green farming system. I'm okay, I'm happy. But I want to dig deep into a particular issue on organic, on the ecology farm system or kind of that. Do you have that one? So I'm saying that, yes, we can serve you, but you need to pay. And then they say, I'm willing to pay, kind of that. So meaning that I got some idea that if, like a professor say in the morning, that if that particular content can really serve that demand, they are willing to pay. So I think that the Thai MOOC is at the beginning of the journey that is very interesting to change the paradigm of the educational system in Thailand. But we cannot walk alone. We learn a lot from this yesterday and this morning. Lesson learned that we better learn from you, and then we also found out our own problem. And then we can see that people are willing to pay if that is meaningful to them, kind of that. So I think that for the money or the cost, if we are professional enough, I think that the money will gain from them. I think that might be a small factor of the business model or sustainable model. Yep. But it's still under try and error, you know. But it's very challenging that even though they are poor, they say, I want a very PCC or very concise content. Can you offer a MOOC for me and into my mobile devices? Kind of that. Because I hold my mobile devices all the time. I don't want to go to the notebook or desktop mobile devices, kind of that. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Well, I wonder, do you provide any fixed amount of money, like a K-MOOC, to an instructor or to school?
Yes. From the project, we provide a fixed amount of budget to the faculty member that create the MOOC course. We have our way of calculation. For 1 hour of the learning, we provide 20,000 baht per hour. So for each cost for the production, we have many categories. The first category is the MOOC cost production, the production cost. For 1 learning hour, we provide 20,000 baht. But so, for example, if the teacher submission that they want to create 10 hours of learning, 10 learning hour course, so they get 200,000 baht for the production. But for the teaching, after the production, the quality MOOC course, and then they have to teaching at least one round, and we provide to them another 10,000 baht, something, 10,000 something for the teaching duty. And also we have a small proportion for the examination item, maybe 5,000 baht something for the examination that they create and submit to the test bank proportion. So totally for one course, one MOOC course that have 10 hours, 10 learning hours, they got maybe 220,000 baht. Small compared to Dr. Thakur had something.
I think Dr. Anuchai have to say about the learning hours. Okay. Because learning hours is not equal to the numbers of video hours.
We have Yes. 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 All everything, and we have. Yes. Yes. To the group of professors that create that course, the team of the professor, for clarify one learning hour maybe combined of the video proportion that we have guideline that one learning hour they should create the video at least 35.
Actually, what they said is a guideline. Generally, we support one institution for one course to develop a 10 teaching hours class, 10 teaching hours. For 10 teaching hours, they will get about $5,700. Okay? $5,700. That includes content development, examination creation, and also teaching for one round. No matter how many students, no matter how many teaching hours. For example, I create 10 teaching hours. Dr. Anuchai create 12 teaching hours class. We get the same amount for the teaching fees. So I'm sorry, Dr. So, but we spend less than your case. So I think we should complain more.
Have small amount of budget. The cost, but the cost from KMOOC is one semester credit. Yeah. The 15 weeks is a credit cost. So 45, you mean 45 learning hours per course. So 3 times. We have to change the issue, change the topic. Maybe many teachers complain. No. Yes, yes, yes. We dedicate to the Hub University that they have a meeting with the member university and they create the criteria, but we have guidelines. We looking forward to this kind of subjects and this kind of condition something, but we dedicate to them that you have to talk to East Region University member. To choose the proper course that benefit to the region, also comply to the guideline. So if you have anything to add, you can. there are many models. For some region, okay. Dr. Thakun,
some explanation. Like my case, I'm in the southern part. So I have, actually I got about 25 applicants that coming into my university saying that they want to develop the MOOC. And then I have a certain criteria, follow the guidelines from the TCU. Yeah, I have the criteria saying that what courses I'm going to give the funding, but follow the guideline from the TCU. So finally, I gave out, I think it's 8 or 10 from 25 applicants. So basically in the South, mostly are Muslim, some of the Muslims, so we give out a lot on the Muslim studies. So that's the case in the South.
Mean that they can select by themselves for the need of that region. Yeah.
The model of the content or cost production, they are different from region to region. For some region, the university, the member university themselves, they create the cost by their own team. But for some region, the major hub, the hub university will be the one who create the cost, the quality cost for the member university. So we have many, many models to learn. Okay, I think we can discuss more at the lunch time or in the afternoon. There are other sessions waiting. Thank you very much for this.
Thank you very much. Well, Professor Anuchai, his nickname is Thai MOOC Daddy. Okay, please allow me to make a housekeeping announcement. We move the program a little bit.